Hello and welcome. This is another video on the lecture series called Unsolved Mysteries of Nature. In this video, I am going to explain the wave particle duality, some thought on wave particle duality. So, this is some new thought on the wave particle duality. According to quantum mechanics, we know that subatomic particle both have wave nature as well as its particle nature. It means sometimes particle behave like a wave as well as also it sometimes behave like a concrete object, concrete object. And it was clear with the help of double slit experiment. In double slit experiment, we can prove that particle is behaving like a wave. It is showing interference pattern. Also, particle also has its own particle nature. So, this is called wave particle duality. It means there is a wave like property as well as there is a particle like property. The problem with this wave particle duality is which one is more real? Wave nature is real or particle nature is real? We don't know whether wave nature is real or particle nature is real. Also, according to the principles of quantum mechanics, we cannot locate a subatomic particle without disturbing it. Ordinary, every object which we see through our eyes, we can locate that particle precisely in the space, in time, through the use of Newtonian's law or law of motion. But same thing cannot be done with what we call small particle, subatomic particle. If we try to find the position of subatomic particle, we will alter that position and its position will be changed. So, that is the difficulty with calculating or finding the position of particle. Also, we can only calculate its probability. So, we can only calculate probability of finding a particle, and that probability is given by the square of the wave function psi x, and this psi x tells everything about that particle. But what is this psi x? What is this wave function? Whether this wave function is real one or it is dependent on the particle, or it is independent from the particle. So, that's the question. Now, according to the double slit experiment, if we take an electron gun which has ability to fire electron one by one towards these two slit, we will get an interference pattern just like a wave. Again, if we put a device behind this double slit to know whether the electron is going from hole A or hole B, then the interference pattern will be stopped and we will get a particle nature, or just like a tennis ball. Suppose this is two hole A and B, and if we fire tennis ball towards A and B, it will receive either at this one or either at this one, either at P or either at Q, in front of the A or in front of the B. It means it has it will be a definite location to particle get this tennis ball. So when we try to put a device behind this double slit, the interference pattern will be destroyed and electron will start behaving like a particle. It means we cannot get particle nature and wave nature at the same time. So this is the my interpretation, that wave nature and particle nature we cannot get at the same time. Now there can be another interpretation of quantum mechanics, which is called superimposition interpretation. Take an example. At the time of sunset or sunrise, yellow sun appears as red. So we can say that redness of the sun is superimposed on the yellow sun. This is the fact one. Fact two is that we cannot observe redness and yellowness at the same time. There is no way we can say that we can see the red color sun and yellow sun at the same time. If one has to appear, another has to go. Also, we can say that the sun has dual nature, but it is not. So these three facts we can get from this simple these three facts. So now we apply this three rule on the double slit experiment. According to superimposition interpretation, we can get two propositions. Proposition one says that particle nature is superimposed on wave nature. Proposition two says that we cannot observe particle aspect and wave aspect at the same time. If we fire a electron gun through double slit experiment, we will see only wave nature of that particle. But if we try to decide whether electron was really a particle, whether it was going through hole A and hole B trying to observe the particle, what will happen? It will manifest as the particle aspect. It means particle aspect and wave aspect cannot appear at the same time. If one wave nature has to manifest, then particle nature has to go. It means the particle location before the observation will be meaningless, as redness before the sun set will be meaningless, and wave nature is real one and particle nature will be due to the observation or due to the apparatus. It means psi xt or probability wave or guiding wave has real existence. This is the real existence. So in the next video or in the upcoming video, I will explore this line of